Hello, my name is Jesse, and today we are going to give a quick tour of the Koha staff client. Remember, the Koha staff client is web-based. That means you can access your Koha system from a laptop, a desktop, even your mobile device. Whether you're at the library or working remotely or even out doing an outreach event, as long as you have access to a browser that allows you to get into your Koha system, you can log in. Now, what you're taking a look at here is the main landing page for the staff client. I am logged in as a super librarian, and that gives me access to all of the modules in the system. Now, when you're setting up your staff permissions, you can set them up to have access to what best meets their workflows in the library. So for example, your frontline staff, they're working with patrons, they're checking things in and out, they're searching for material in the system. They may only see some of these top modules like circulation, patrons, advanced search, and maybe even lists. You can customize that in your system. Now, let's talk about this menu up top. This allows staff to easily jump into circulation and begin the process of checking things out or checking things in, pulling the holds that they need to grab from the shelf in the morning, or even running a quick overdues report. The patrons module allows you to begin the process of creating a new patron in the system or even searching for a patron of a particular category. Once you're in that layout, you can then go a little bit further and make some adjustments. Now, there are two advanced search features here in the Koha staff client. One that allows you to narrow down using that Boolean search and multiple facets, or an item search, which really allows you to narrow down by a status or a collection. The More dropdown here will give you access to all of the modules that you have. Koha is very good at providing ways for you to easily navigate through the system. Remember, your Koha logo in the upper left-hand corner will easily take me back to that main screen. Now let's talk about some help options for staff. In the upper right-hand corner, you'll see a help menu. That's going to take me right out to the Koha Community Manual, where you can either search for a topic or you can browse the table of contents. Once you find exactly what you're looking for, that will take you in where you can view step-by-step instructions with screenshots to help you through. Now, let's talk about the news feature over here on the left. That can be customized so staff can see exactly what's going on at the library, whether it's a link out to a database or one of your jobbers that you order from, or even a quick tutorial video. These can be customized for each one of your libraries so they can see exactly what's going on. I've even seen some great examples where libraries have embed calendars in there so they can see what's happening exactly at the library. At the bottom of the page, your staff will be alerted to anything that's pending in the system, whether it's a purchase suggestion, an OPAC problem that was reported, or even comments or tags that are pending approval. This gives staff easy access where they can jump right in and make those modifications and approve them or reject them before moving forward. Now, through the layout here, of course, we can see all of those other modules in the system, like course reserves, which allows us to manage courses for our library. The authorities module allows you to, of course, search for existing authorities in the system or create new authorities from a Z3950 search or a new original authority in the system. Your cataloging module allows you to do multiple cataloging functions, whether you're looking for a new title from a Z3950 search, or you're creating a new record from scratch using one of Koha's built-in frameworks. There are two different editors in Koha. One is an advanced editor, which is keyboard driven with keyboard shortcuts, built-in settings, and the ability to create text strings. The other is a basic editor. The basic editor is mouse-driven with 10 tabs across the top that easily allow you to come in, make changes to your record, and quickly link out to the Library of Congress for any questions that you may have about indicators or codes for subfields. Now, the Tools module for cataloging has a tie-in that will allow you to do actions. So anytime you're in Tools, you can perform actions, whether it's batch deletion or modification of an item or a record, exporting your data, running an inventory, or importing records that you get from one of your vendors, like Baker & Taylor, Gobi, Midwest Tapes, Midwest Library Services. This allows you to perform actions for those records. Now, furthering the conversation about your technical services, we have serials. That allows us to keep track of our subscriptions, receive our materials, and even place claims. Within the acquisitions module, you have four basic functions. The first being the budget, which allows you to track the funds in your fiscal year, tied into things that have been ordered and spent, and to keep an eye on what's still available in each one of those. The second one is your vendors. This is where we can track information about our vendor, ordering, discounts, tax, delivery time, and even those contacts. Step three is creating the orders. This is where you create orders to a basket and then finally receive those shipments in the system. The acquisitions module allows you to look at your invoices, keep an eye on those late orders, and then of course run any quick reports, whether it's by funds or holds, or using a quick statistic wizard. Finally, let's talk a little bit about reports. Reports in Koha allow you to perform any type of select statement where you can grab data out of the system. So for example, we can look at account reports for fines and fees, acquisitions for our collection development team, catalog reports if we need to make any changes or cleanup, circulation to check our numbers, and then of course collection to development to further analyze our collection. These reports can be created from scratch or by searching from a database of other existing reports that Koha users have entered. Finally, we'll talk about Koha administration. This is where we set up everything in your system to define libraries and item types, setting up your patrons and circulation, and then of course defining how cataloging works, setting up those frameworks, classification sources, and matching rules in the system. Remember, Koha is a fully functioning web-based ILS. For more, check out our tutorials on bywatersolutions.com or our YouTube channel with Bywater Solutions. Thank you.